تسكولا شيم ربوت نعموت وتوبوت. We're all familiar with the Gemara Masechet Gittin at the time of the rebellion of Beit HaMikdash Hasheni, the second temple, where Rabbi Yohanan ben Zakkai, Rabban Yohanan ben Zakkai, met Aspasianus. Now Aspasianus was the Roman general, he wasn't the king yet, but Rabban Yohanan ben Zakkai greeted him and he said, Shalom Malka, greetings unto you my king, my royal majesty. So Aspasianus, as we said, wasn't the king, so he said, Yahayab tumitot, Yahayab death twice. Number one, why are you calling me the king? I'm not a king. Yomurid b'malchut, you're rebelling against the king. Number two, if I am the king, how come it took you so long to come to me? I'll read you the words. Imalka'ana ad ha'idna amai la'atit l'gabai. If I am really the king, how come it took you such a long time to come to me? So Rabban Yohanan ben Zakkai answers him, Biryone de'id ban la shakinan. Because there's a lot of people, a lot of tough guys, didn't let me come to you because they don't want me to come to you. So the Chachmei Musar take the story in the Gemara and they say, this applies to Yamim Noraim. It applies to the days of awe. It applies to right before Kippur. Hashem says, you just finished Rosh Hashanah. You were saying, HaMelech HaKadosh, HaMelech HaMishpat. It's all about Melech. But Hashem asks one question. Im Malka'ana Ad ha'idna amai la'atit la'gabai. If I am really the king, how come it took you so long to come to me? It's beautiful. I saw you in Rosh Hashanah. But how come it took you so long? We're approaching Yom Kippur. Do we understand the meaning of Yom Kippur? As we said, the beautiful gift that Hashem has granted us. What's the point of Yom Kippur? We have to do teshuvah. We have to repent to come back to our king, to come back to our father. Hashem asks, why did it take you so long? I miss you so much. I just want to be with you. I just want to hug you. Why did it take you so long? So what do we answer? Rabban Yohanan ben Zakkai answered, because we have a lot of tough guys. They didn't let me come. Who's the tough guy in our life? Who's the biggest oyeb? Who's the biggest enemy? Public enemy number one? That's the Yetzer Hara. He's the tough guy. Hashem, I really wanted to come back to you. Hashem, I wanted to do teshuvah. But it's not my fault. You know, he's stopping me. He doesn't want me to do teshuvah. He's stopping me from coming to you. We have to know something. Now, there's a misconception that teshuvah is very hard. Yes, maybe a full teshuvah is really hard. Maybe to come back fully to Hashem, maybe it requires more than 3 steps. But just the beginning of teshuvah is really easy. And you don't have to take upon yourselves grandiose things, major things, grand things. No. Even a small teshuvah is considered a teshuvah. Even something small to take upon yourself is considered a step in the right direction to come back to Hashem. A person tells you, you know, I really wanted to wear tzitzit. It's really hard, but what could I do? It's really hard to put tzitzit on. The question is, how come he doesn't say this to all his other clothings? How come he doesn't say, you know, it's really hard to put a shirt on? Everybody wears a shirt. Everybody wears pants, shoes, socks, belt. How come they don't use that excuse for the other clothings only when it comes to tzitzit? Or better yet, they say, I'm coming, I'll wear tzitzit, but not now. I need a few years, a few months. Let me build up to it. So now what do you tell the person? So do you say that to your other articles of clothing? Do you put one shoe on now and say, okay, I'll put the other shoe on in 3 years from now, in a few months from now, let me build up to it? Of course not. But again, like we said, maybe to put on tzitzit is very hard. Maybe I'm not used to it. Maybe it's a little bothersome. But Hashem wants to see the step in the right direction. He wants to see you attempting. You don't have to put it on every single day. If you want to try, put it on once a week. Put it on only on Shabbat. However, there's no excuse not to. And this applies with all the other mitzvot. I'm not per se particular on tzitzit. But Hashem says, if I'm the king, how come it took you so long to come to me? And we say, Hashem, it's a Yetzer Hara. But Hashem says, but there is no Yetzer Hara. It's all imaginations. It's all demyonot. It's all in your brain. It's you that are not letting yourself be the best of yourself. Be the best person that you can be. Forget about the Yetzer Hara. Just come to me. Just talk to me direct. And that's the point of Yom Kippur. The point of Yom Kippur is repenting, to coming back to Hashem with teshuvah. Even if it's not teshuvah shelema, at least the step in the right direction. That's what Hashem wants from us. And we have to know also that as much as the Yetzer Hara tries to fool us, it's time that we fool him. As much as the Yetzer Hara tries to get one up on us, it's time to get one up on him. It's time to bring him down. Yes, and the best time to do it is these days. Even leading, even before Yom Kippur, leading up to Yom Kippur, the Aseret Yemei Teshuvah, you have the chance to fix every day in Aseret Yemei Teshuvah. You have the chance to fix that day from the whole year. Monday fixes all the Mondays, Tuesdays, and so on and so forth. That day when you repent, you have the opportunity to fix all the Mondays, all the Tuesdays, all the Wednesdays, every day. I mean, Hashem says you don't have to do something big. Just take something small upon yourself and you could change your whole life around. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu is waiting. HaKadosh Baruch Hu, like the Tanat Beliyah, who says, more than a father is waiting for a son to come home after a long night, and the door is always open, and he's waiting for a son on the couch, and when the son comes, he gives him a big hug, and he cries, he says, I missed you so much, thank you for coming back home. HaKadosh Baruch Hu, God Almighty, the King, is waiting for us to come back home, and the door is always open, lest we ever forget it. The door is always open for Teshuvah, as we have been saying in Selichot, Ki menecha peshuta lekabel shabim. Ki menecha, Hashem, your right hand is peshuta. You extend it lekabel shabim, to bring back the people shabim. But I'd like to maybe say something else. Ki menecha peshuta lekabel shabim. The word peshuta means extended, but it could also mean pashut. It's so easy. Hashem, it's so easy to come back to you. It's so easy to do teshuvah, because I know, Hashem, you're waiting for me. All it requires is for me to have that first step, for me to show you, Hashem, that I do want to come back to you. And the Pasuk says, Shuba Yisrael ad Hashem Elohecha. Repent, O Israel, and come back straight to God. And the Gemara already says, the Teshuvah is so awesome that when a person does Teshuvah and repents, he comes right next to Hashem's throne of glory. Hashem, right next to Hashem's Kisei HaKavod. Now again, we think it's very hard. Maybe like we said, the full Teshuvah process is hard. But the beginning is very easy. The rabbis say it's analogous to a king that built an Armon. He built a tower with 1,000 floors. And he said, whoever reaches the 1,000th floor, whoever reaches all the way on top, he'll get this huge treasure filled with gold and riches and diamonds and jewelry. So now everybody attempted. First guy goes up, first floor, second floor, third floor. It's too much. He's out of breath. Another guy, 10 floors. Another guy, 20 floors. Another guy said, listen, everybody's failing, but it has to be possible. If the king says it's possible, it's got to be possible. I mean, he won't put us in a predicament. He won't put us in a state where something's impossible to do. It's just not fair to us. So he starts going up and up and up. He reaches the 40th, the 50th floor, and he's walking up the steps and he can't do it anymore. He's about to come down. He looks to his right and he sees an elevator. He presses the button. It goes all the way up to the 1,000th floor. Over there, he has a treasure. He has jewelry. He has the riches. He has the gold. He's happy. Hashem won't put us in this world against the Yetzer Hara if it's not possible to defeat him. It's just not a fair match. It's just not a fair match. Hashem says, Shuba Yisrael, Ad Hashem Elohecha. If you want to repent, I'm here to help you. I don't require you to do it alone. No, it's impossible to do it alone. As we will say in Yom Kippur, Ki hu me'esh ve'ani basar v'adam. The Yetzer Hara is fire, and I'm just flesh and bones and blood. I can't against him. You're right, you can't against him. Already the Gemara Masechet Kiddushin says, if not for Hashem helping us against the Yetzer Hara, there is no shot against the Yetzer Hara. And Hashem is not requiring of you to do it alone. Hashem is saying, do your best, and then know that I'm right behind you. I have your back. You have that button, you go all the way on top. Ad Hashem Elohecha. You reach all the way on top, and I'm waiting for you, Hashem says. I am waiting for you. This Kippur, I am waiting for you. Let me hear you cry out, even before Kippur. Let me hear you cry out every single day this week. Let me hear you cry out, Hashem, I want you. Hashem, I want to repent. I want to be the best version of myself this year. Rabbi Haskel Levinstein, Alav Shalom, Zecher Sadiq V'Kadosh Bracha, used to tell students in the yeshiva of Ponovich, please, don't be like cats. Someone they asked him, Rabbi, what do you mean don't be like cats? What kind of musar is that? kind of lesson is that? Don't be like cats. He says, you don't know who the cat was? Oh, let me tell you the story of the cat. The Rambam had an argument with the king. The king said that it's possible to train a cat to be a waiter. It's possible to train a cat to overcome his desires of eating and running after animals. It's possible. It's possible to even make him a waiter to wait on tables. So Rambam says, let me see this. Let me see if it's possible to actually train an animal to be like a human being. So the king got his best advisors. He got the best of his teachers, of his professors. And they actually taught the cat to wait on tables. Now the cat had a little napkin over here. And he had the menu in the other hand. And he was waiting on tables. So the Rambam says, I'll show them that they're all wrong. The Rambam took out a snuff box, a tabak, a small snuff box. He opened it up. There was a mouse inside of it. He took the mouse. He let it go. The cat saw the mouse. It jumped on the mouse. It forgot to wait on the tables. Everything is upside down. The forks, the knives, the spoons, the plates. The whole thing is disaster. And they saw the cat running after the mouse. So Rabbi Haskel Levinstein says, don't be like the cat. This Kippur, you're promising to repent. But don't be like the cat that right after Kippur, you forget everything. You jump back to your evil desires. You jump back to your evil inclination. You leave everything behind. It's possible to change. It is possible. Don't let the Yesara fool you. Don't let this Biryon, this tough guy in your way, stopping you from being the best version of yourself this Yom Kippur. Be'teshubah, whether it's Teshubah Be'ahaba, whether it's Teshubah Mir'ah, you have the chance, the opportunity right now, right here, to repent, to come back to Hashem, because Hashem is always waiting for you. The Ben Ish Chai says that Teshubah, again, like we said, Hashem doesn't require great things from us. Teshubah le'at le'at, lo be'pa'am ahat, the Ben Ish Chai says. Lo be'pa'am ahat. If you want to say to yourself, I want to leave everything behind, I want to get rid of my TV, or get rid of everything that I have, it's not possible. Because the next day you're going to say, what did I do? I miss my old shows. I miss my old things. It's not possible. Le'at le'at. One day of the week, 2 days of the week, maybe 3 days of the week. The sisit, put it on slowly, slowly. Not required every single day. I mean, it's great if you can, of course. But le'at le'at, the Ben Ish Chai says, slowly, slowly. He says, he gives you a mashal. He says, there's a mashal, there's an analogy. That there was a person that he had a fox. And the fox was a nice pet when it was small. But it grew older. And now he has to take care of this fox. So now what does the person do? He says, I can't take care of this fox. You know, it's a dangerous pet to have around. It's a dangerous animal. But now I'm in a problem right now. I don't know what to do. I'm in a dilemma. If I go and kill the fox will see me and jump on me and kill me. And if I leave the fox around, again, it's a dangerous animal. I can't just leave it around. I'll go and start damaging or even worse. So what does he do? He gives the fox to eat, but not every single day. Instead of giving him every single day, he gives him Monday, Wednesday, maybe sometimes on Thursday, maybe sometimes on Musa Shabbat, sometimes on Sunday. Slowly, slowly, till his strength, till the fox's strength diminishes, slowly, slowly, and he dies himself. The Ben Ish Chai says, that's the Yesarara. To try to defeat him in one shot, it's not possible. But you can do it slowly, slowly, in slow increments, very slow. Say, okay, you want me to do this today? Okay, again, not suggested. I'm saying this is a way to overcome him. Okay, maybe I'll do it today. I'll do it tomorrow. But don't one shot leave everything behind, because it's not possible. But slowly, slowly, you wean away the Yesarara. He goes away from you slowly, slowly, because I'm wasting my time with this person. I had him in the beginning, he was doing Abirot every single day. But now I can't work with a person that does only Sundays and Tuesdays and Thursdays. I'm not a person like that. I need a full-time job. Let me go to somebody else. So you wean him slowly, slowly, and when he sees that he has no shot with you, no chance, he leaves. He doesn't want to waste his time with you. Rabbi Again, Alav Shalom, the great Rabbi Again, Rabbi Nisim Again, the great Mahzir B'Tshuba. He says, we're so fortunate to have a father, a caring, loving father that loves us so much. And like we said, he's waiting for us to do Teshuvah. We've been saying in the Yamin Ra'im, Abinu Malkenu. Hashem is our Father. Hashem is our King. It's not enough to remember that Hashem is our King. Don't forget, Hashem is your Father. Abinu Malkenu. Hashem is your Father. Hashem loves you more than you will ever imagine. There was a boy playing by the ocean, playing by the sand, making sand castles, playing with his bucket, with his shovel. And now he sees a cruise liner. He sees an ocean liner passing by. And he waves. He starts waving. And now people, the passerby, are saying, well, what are you doing? You're waving to this huge ship? It's very far away. What are you waving? He ignores them. He keeps on waving. And now other people pass by and they say, little kid, what are you doing? Who are you waving to? You know how far away the ship is? You know how big this ocean is? Who are you waving to? And even if you're waving, what do you think? The captain of the ship is going to stop everything and do his horn, his just, this is just for you? You're wasting your time. He said, I'm so confident that the captain of the ship will sound his horn. You say, how are you so confident? He says, because the captain of the ship is my Father. And the captain of the ship knows, and my Father knows that I play over here in the sand with my mother, with my siblings. And he's waiting for me from a distance. He wants to see me waving. He has his telescope. He sees very far away. He knows I'm waving to him. And when he sees me waving for him, he'll wave back. He'll sound his horn. So again, Alav Hashem says, that's the mashal. The moral lesson is, Hashem is just waiting for you to wave. Hi, Hashem, I'm right here. I want to repent. I want to come back to you. I love you so much. Hashem, please, please accept me. I wasn't the best, but this year I want to be the best version of myself. Hashem says, oh, you're waving to me. Wow, I see you from a distance. You see me. I see you waving to me. Oh, I see you waving to me. Let me wave to you back. Let me shower you with abundance of gifts. Let me shower you with beracha, with atzlaha, with refuah, with revaha, with atzlaha, with all the good in the world. Because you're waving to me. Because a father always wants his son to come back home. That's the meaning of teshuvah. That's the meaning of repentance. Teshuvah makes the word teshub he. Come back to the he. What's the he? What's the letter he? He is Hashem. Come back to Hashem. Teshuvah. Come back to Hashem. He is the Hashem. Hashem is waiting for us to come back to him. Let me read you what the Midrash Itamari says. Rabbi Eliyahu HaKohen of Izmir, the Baal Shevet Musar. He says like this. Behamlat Hashem al amo v'tzom ar'ito. Because Hashem has so much compassion over his nation, over his flock. Hashab mahashabot lebilti yidach mimenu nidach. Hashem always thinks of different ways how to bring us back, because he doesn't want us to go astray. Ubana olamo al yesod teshuba. And he has built his world only for teshuba. Liyod bet manos lemachisim shemo. To be a place, a shelter where they could run away. If they ever angered Hashem, they could run away to this teshuvah, do teshuvah and come back to Hashem. When you run to this shelter, you find shelter. In this shelter, you find Hashem. You find the rahamim of Hashem. You find the compassion of Hashem. You find the mercy, the kindness of Hashem. You know why? Because he says the koach teshuvah, the power of teshuvah is so great. It's not shayach to this world. Hashem created teshuvah even before he created the world. Because if Hashem created this world and there was no concept of teshuvah, the world will crumble. What would happen if a person sins? He doesn't have that power of teshuvah. Therefore, Hashem created teshuvah even before he created this world. That's why teshuvah is something we'll never fathom, we'll never understand. How could it be a person went and he rebelled against the King Almighty? But he does teshuvah, and Hashem, like the Rambam says, he brings him back and he puts him on an even higher level. Why? Because that's the power of teshuvah. That's the energy of teshuvah. Special and important, the mitzvah of teshuvah. It's a mitzvah. Every time a person does teshuvah, it's an actual mitzvah of the Torah. He's fulfilling a commandment from the Torah. Why is it a commandment? Because Hashem wants us to do teshuvah. Hashem wants us to repent, to come back to Him. And we're all familiar with the words of Debrei Rabbeinu Yonah, of Rabbeinu Yonah, the beginning of a Sha'arei Teshuvah, his great masterpiece, quotes the Midrash in Kohelet. And he says there were a few people that were locked up in prison, in jail. And it's like an escape from Alcatraz kind of thing. And they all they all got together and they said, that's it, tomorrow night, we're going to break out of jail. We'll do something, we're going to break out of prison. We can't take it anymore. Sure enough, the next day, they're planning on it the whole day. In the night, they do some kind of thing, and they finally escape. But there was one guy, he said, no, I'm not escaping. I'm staying here. The next morning, when the prison guard is coming to see all the inmates, he sees this one guy and the three people that were with him flee. They're not there anymore. So he says, where's your buddies? Where's your friends? He says, they escaped, but I stayed. I'm the good person. So the prison guard starts hitting him. He says, what are you hitting me? I'm the one who stayed. He says, you fool. You had a chance. You had a way to leave. You had a way to escape. And you didn't take it. Rabbeinu Yonah says, that's us. We have Yom Kippur. We have Aser Yemei Teshuvah. We have the chance of Teshuvah, of repentance. And we're not taking it. What does Hashem say? I gave you a mitzvah of Teshuvah. I gave you the 10 days. I gave you Yom Kippur. And you're not taking advantage of it. What kind of fool are you, Chas V'Shalom? Take advantage of the day. And Hashem wants us to repent. Hashem wants us to come back to Him bechol ayat u'bechol zeman. Any given moment, any given time, when a person does Teshuvah, Hashem will take him, Hashem will elevate him. Like we said, the Rambam, Hashem will elevate him and even put him on a higher level. If you want to go with that Gemara, Masechet Barachot, b'makom sheba'alei teshuvah omdin tzadikim gemurim einam yechol na'amod. At a place where the ba'al teshuvah, when a person repents and does teshuvah, he's on an even higher level than the people that never sinned a day in their life. And that's a totally different topic, which we don't have time to talk about it right now. But Hashem makes Himself available to us. And the Rambam says, even though we have a mitzvah of teshuvah to do all year round, but in these 10 days, Aser Yemei Teshuvah, Hashem, as if you want to say, He cleared up His schedule. He canceled all His calls, all His meetings. It's only us and Hashem. Hashem says, I'm available to you. Dirshu Hashem b'himatseo, dera'u b'yoto karob. Call out to Hashem when He's next to us. What do you mean when He's next to us? He's always next to us. You're right, He is always next to you. But now He's even closer. Now He came down. Now He's even closer. As the Hasidic Masters say, Hamelech basadeh, the King is in the field. He's in the field, so it's very easy to come to Him. It's very easy to connect with Him, to talk to Him. And He wants to elevate you. He wants to talk to you. He wants to hug you. He wants to come back together with you. And even before we come to Kippur, in these days, and these days of Aser Yemei Teshuvah, let's prepare a list of what we want to do Teshuvah on. Because if we come to Yom Kippur and we say, Hashem, forgive me for this, we'll start forgetting. Let's make a list of what we want to change this year. Let's make a list of how we want to connect to Hashem. In what ways do we want to connect to Hashem? Let's make this list beforehand. Don't come on Yom Kippur and then start babbling things out and then start saying things out. It's a mashal of a person, of an Ashir, a very rich person. He wanted to marry off his daughter. He wanted the Shadchan. He said, look, I'm not looking for a person with money. I'm not looking for a person that is tall or handsome. I'm looking for a good person that has a head on his shoulders. That's all I require of you. I want a person with a head on his shoulders and he has to have brains. So the Shadchan says, look, I have a few guys. I have a perfect person. But the only problem is he stutters. He has a stuttering problem. He has a stuttering issue. So the Ashir, the rich person, says, no problem. As long as he has brains, as long as he has a head on his shoulders, I'm fine with it. He says, yes, head on his shoulders, you got it. He says, no problem. Let him come to my office tomorrow. I want to meet him. So the Shadchan hangs up. He calls the person. He says, tomorrow meet this rich person by so-and-so, by the address. He gives him the address to meet him. The next day, he knocks on the door, this potential Hatan. He knocks on the door of the rich person. He knocks on the door and he says, the rich person opens the door and the person says, Shalom. Hello. But he stutters. So the rich person says, oy vey, what did I get myself into? The meeting, okay. He finished the meeting. The person leaves. He calls the Shadchan. He says, what did you do? Why did you send me this person? So the Shadchan says, you told me a stuttering problem is stuttering, it's not an issue. It's not a problem. You want a person with a head on his shoulders, with brains. He says, yes, but this person doesn't have brains. He says, what do you mean he doesn't have brains? His, because if he knows that he has a stuttering problem, let him start his shalom at home. And by the time he gets to me, he has the complete word out, shalom. But he chose to stutter right in front of my doorstep. Shalom. He has no brains. He has no head. Hashem says, Ki'ilu, that's us. That's the Mashiach, the Nimshaz, that's us. We come to Yom Kippur. Hashem, we want this. Hashem, we want this. We start stuttering. We don't know what to even ask Hashem for forgiveness. Hashem says, Hello. Relax. Calm down. I gave you 10 days. Aseret Yemei Teshuvah, leading up to the Yom Teshuvah, the great day of Kippur. But stutter before. Do me a favor, stutter before. Don't come to Yom Kippur and start asking me things that I don't understand what you're saying. Start stuttering beforehand. Start making a list. These days are to make a list of what we want to change, of how we want to connect to Hashem, what we want Hashem to forgive us for, and again, to be the best version of ourselves. And we'll end off with this. Rabbi Levi Yitzhak of Berdichev says, we say in Yom Kippur, Melech mohel v'soleach la'avonotin, we thank Hashem, not thank Hashem, we bless Hashem for forgiving all our sins. The question is, we're blessing Hashem for forgiving all our sins, but Hashem didn't forgive our sins yet. How are we so confident that Hashem is going to forgive our sins? So Rabbi Levi Yitzhak of Berdichev says, there's two kids. One kid has a snack, and he's not sharing with his friend. His friend really wants that cookie. So what does he do? Very clever kid. He says, Baruch atah Hashem, Elokei melech haolam, borei meni mezonot. Now his friend is forced to give him a cookie, so the beracha is not a beracha lebatala, so it's not a beracha in vain, so it doesn't say Hashem's name in vain. So he's forced to give him the cookie. Very clever kid. So that's what the pasuk is saying. That's what the beracha is saying. Once we say, Hashem, we bless you because you forgive us, Hashem says, I have to forgive them now. I don't want my name to be in vain. I have to forgive them. So it's as if we're forcing Hashem, as if we're forcing Hashem to forgive us. The whole world rests on Yom Kippur. The whole world is waiting for us to do teshuva, to elevate ourselves, to elevate the whole world in the same process, in the same time, to come back to Hashem. The pasuk says, "Ki bayom hazeh yechaper alechem letaher etchem." Ki bayom hazeh, ki, because of this day, this is the day you will be forgiven. We have the word ki. Ki is Rashi Tevot, is the acronym of Yom Kippurim. Everything rests on Yom Kippurim. Even the creation of the world was created because of Yom Kippurim. What a great gift Hashem has given us. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to spread some Torah with you. Hopefully we could all elevate ourselves, be the best versions of ourselves, come back to Hashem, repent to Hashem, do teshuvah, and this is the year we'll finally come together, Be'azat Hashem, with the rebuilding of Beit HaMikdash, with the Bi'at Mashiach Tzedkenu, B'mera B'amenu, Amen V'Amen, Tizku L'Shem Rabot, Ne'emot V'Tobot.